Hello, Legion. I'm Gerald Undone, and today I'm going to talk about streaming. Now, this is going to be a pretty technical video, so to the rest of my subscribers that maybe are looking for a little bit more of an upbeat or fun video, this is not going to be it. This is going to be pretty technical. So if you aren't interested in that, feel free to skip this one and check back tomorrow. But for everybody else who's interested in streaming, using OBS and wants to see some comparison stuff and understand some differences between, you know, NVENC codecs and x264 codecs and whether to use your CPU or your GPU, that's what this video is going to be about. It's going to be all about streaming. So let's get undone. Gerald Undone. He's crazy. So yesterday I decided to try and stream for the first time using this channel, and I encountered some difficulties. I was using OBS because I use it for local recordings, and so I figured it'd be pretty easy transition to the streaming. But there's a whole lot of hurdles that I encountered regarding the streaming that I had to sort of overcome. And when I looked online, although there's quite a bit of resources for OBS and for streaming, a lot of them seemed out of date. A lot of the tutorials that I looked at featured software that has things in locations that doesn't even match mine, because I'm using OBS Studio and a lot of people still have the tutorials for OBS Classic. So this will hopefully serve as an information session for people interested in streaming or people who already are streaming and want to improve a little bit, and some things that I found. I've got quite a few comparisons and benchmarks to share with you. Okay, so let's start with just a little bit of an introduction on OBS, because that's what I've been using to stream, and that's what this tutorial is going to be about. So this is OBS Studio. It's a little bit different than the OBS Classic that a lot of the guides and tutorials that are available now are featuring. So over here you've got your settings on the right, you've got a mixer right here, and you've got your sources. So if you've never used OBS before, I'll give you a quick little rundown. You add sources here by hitting the plus, and that's where you add in, say, like, I have GTA 5 in case you want to capture a video game, if you want to do a webcam, if you want to capture your screen, that kind of thing. Over here, you add audio sources, and you can bring up the mixer, and you can change the levels that you want the different volumes to be at. Or if one of them's out of sync, you can delay it that way as well. Then over here, you've got start streaming, start recording, or stop recording, because I'm recording this video right now through OBS, and then you've got your settings. Now, if we take a look at the settings, a lot of these are just preference, but we'll skip most of them. And here's where you're gonna set your streaming services. If you're streaming to YouTube or streaming to Twitch, you're gonna put it in here and put in the key. Most of the guides online for that stuff is all pretty consistent. Audio, you know, I mean, you can put your inputs and outputs in the sample rate. I wouldn't worry too much about that right now. And hotkeys, and then advanced. So really what we need to worry about is output. Now, I'm gonna talk about streaming. I have my recording outputs, but we're not gonna talk about local recording right now, because I don't really find many issues with local recording, because with local recording, you can just jack the bitrate way up and you'll have a good recording, because bitrate isn't as important because you're not streaming, so it doesn't really matter. What I'm gonna talk about is streaming right now. So with streaming, this is grayed out because I'm recording currently, so I'm not able to change it, but here you would have your encoder. And I have three different encoders to choose from. One is the one you see here right now, which is NVENC H.264. This is using my NVIDIA graphics card. So there's a lot of talk online about how, you know, this is the most efficient, but the worst quality. The other two options are QuickSync, which is Intel's chip using the Intel graphics card that allows you to encode video. So you're offloading, so you're not using the video card that you're using for gaming, and you're not using the cores of the CPU that are used for processing the encoding. You're using an extra chunk of the CPU in the iGPU. And then the other option is x264, which is purely software CPU based. Now this one will have a big hit on your system, and it's because it uses the processor to encode and compress on the fly. Now, if you are playing something, if you're using some CPU intensive, then using x264 might be tricky for you. Now, it's important when talking about these three different codecs to keep in mind, this is primarily for people who are streaming from the PC that they're also doing the content on, whether that's playing a game or, you know, video, whatever it is. If you're capturing from another source, if you're capturing from, say, you've got a console, a PlayStation 4, Xbox, whatever, hooked up, and you're capturing from that, well, the console is handling all the load of playing the game. So all the computer needs to do in that case is render and code compress. So in that case, you could probably use the CPU one, because there are some advantages of that, and you can use, you know, 90% of your CPU on encoding, because you're not using it to play the game. I try to do it all at once. I try to stream the game or whatever I'm doing from the computer that I'm doing it on, so I need to save as much CPU as possible. So I was trying to look into see whether or not, like, what the best quality I could get using either NVIDIA or QuickSync in order to stream, because when I was using x264, it was a bit hard on my system. And I'll show you a couple benchmarks in a second. But secondly, I'm just gonna go through these real quick. So the rate control, yeah, CBR, VBR, CQP, and lossless. So CBR and VBR, you'll see them everywhere. CBR is constant bitrate and VBR is variable bitrate. So constant bitrate means just what it sounds like. You put a bitrate in here, so say I've got 8,000 written in. That means it's gonna try to maintain 8,000 for your bitrate all the time. And this is measured in kilobits per second, the bitrate. So we've got 8,000 kilobits per second or 8 megabits per second. And it'll try to keep that consistent. If we put it to variable bitrate, then the bitrate works more like a target. Like, you know, it's gonna try to float around the 8,000 kilobits per second. But in scenes that's really intense, it might have to up it. And in ones where there's not, it's just a static image, it can lower the bitrate. So variable bitrate generally creates sort of better quality and file size. But for streaming, a lot of people recommend constant bitrate because at least then you're gonna have a steady flow of data through the stream, which is better for buffering and for receiving something consistent on the other end. Keyframe interval, you're gonna wanna set it to 2. Then the preset here for, this is the preset for NVENC. I find default to be the best. And profile, I've read a bunch about this. A lot of people say main, and I think that's because of compatibility in the past. But I've done a few comparisons on a bunch of different devices, and I've also read a bunch about it. And most tech experts agree that these days, anything that can handle main can handle high, and vice versa. There's not a lot of devices that will only be able to take main, and that high will be incompatible. So that's the basic settings. For each setting type, there's going to be different settings for here, different presets and that kind of thing. With X264, you'll have, so I'm gonna jump over to my recording tab just to show you, because I have the other options here. If you set the encoder to X264, you're gonna have different things like CPU usage preset, which has anything ultrafast, superfast, veryfast, all the way down. Now, the higher that you set this, so if you set it to ultrafast, it's gonna use less of your CPU. It says it right here, higher equals less CPU. What this means is that the load that we were talking about that it's gonna put on it will be easier if you set it on ultra fast, and if you set it down to very slow, the load on your CPU is gonna be immense. Now, the reason why you would adjust this though is that each one of these steps as you get down towards the slower settings will conduct a cleaner, better compression, but it requires more CPU power. Think of it this way, you'll get more bang for your bitrate the lower you set this. So if you set it to very slow, and you set the bitrate to, say, 3500, which is the Twitch standard, then your 3500 will be much better on very slow than your 3500 on ultra fast. So those are the settings you need to worry about, is the CPU usage preset if you're going to be using X264, and if you're using NVENC, the preset over here, which is like default high quality Blu-ray. I personally found default to be the best. Now, let's talk a little bit about what actually happens and show you some comparisons. Now for this example, I did it 4500 for everything, for all three codecs. I know with Twitch it's 3500. I stream to YouTube, so 4500 is fine. The lower the bitrate, the better X264 is over NVENC. I found 4500 to be sort of the crossover point where if you run average settings on X264, they look about the same as NVENC on 4500. So let's look at a couple examples here. So this is all using playing Grand Theft Auto 5. And the reason why I chose Grand Theft Auto 5 is because it has a lot of motion and it's also very CPU intensive. So that's important because we're talking about how to be able to play and load things with your CPU being capped out. So in the top corners here, I have MSI, Afterburners, Riva Tuner, telling me the statistics. So basically it shows me my frame rate while I'm playing, because that's important to see how much of a frame rate drop you're gonna get. The CPU usage in percentage. And then I also have my GPU usage. And I have like my core and clocks and fan speed. So this will let me know how much of the CPU is being used, how much of the GPU is being used, and what kind of frame rate I'm getting. So on the left-hand side here, we've got X264, which is software, And on the right-hand side, we've got NVENC, which uses the graphics card. So I'll tell you my observations. To me, the X264 looks a little bit more contrasty, a little bit more saturated in the color. The NVENC looks a tiny bit washed out. I would say it's pretty minimal, but I do notice it. As far as the pixelatedness, which comes with the bitrate, as I was trying to point out, I think you'll find that they're very similar. In some respects, I actually think that the NVENC looks better, despite, you know, forums and everything saying that X264 always looks better. So this is why I was saying that at about 4500 bitrate, you'll find that NVENC is about equal or maybe even slightly pulls ahead. Now the preset for X264 during this was very fast. That's when I was showing you the settings in here. This is a quick little reminder. Between the CPU of ultrafast, veryfast, fast, medium, slow. So I put it on veryfast, which used a decent amount of the CPU, but gave me a little bit better quality than ultrafast. I find that at 4500 bitrate, X264 doesn't look better than NVENC until after fast or slower than that. Once you start setting it to medium, slow, slower, even at very fast, I'll show you the benchmarks again. So if we look here, the CPU usage over here for NVENC is only 41%, where the CPU usage over here for X264 is 77%. That's 30% more of the CPU in order to render it with the CPU. And if we look at some frame rates while traveling over here, it's silky smooth at 60 frames a second all the time. And the playability from personal experience, I found it to feel so smooth. And so the GPU gets up to 70% usage and the CPU is 55%. Over here, the frame rates are dropping 50, 51, 54, 53. So I'm losing 7 to 10 frames because of the CPU usage. And the CPU is at 82% and the GPU at 75. Now that's interesting. If we're using the GPU to encode over here, why would the GPU be lower in its usage over here? And an interesting little thing that happened for me, I don't know if it'll happen for everybody, but it's worth pointing out, is that because I'm using the GPU, it actually bumped up the overclock. So I'm using a GTX 970 and I have it overclocked, you know, up to like 1500 megahertz, but the overclock doesn't kick in unless it's the power is required. So on the left-hand side, because this is a pretty CPU intensive game, it was comfortable using 75% of the CPU at only 1100 megahertz core clock. But over here, once I started using the NVIDIA encoder, it required more from the graphics card, so it upped the core clock to 1518, which then meant that the game only needed 68% of that 1518 because it's a higher core clock. So the GPU usage was actually lower because the core clock was higher. So I found that to be quite interesting. And because the core clock was also higher, it made for a much more fluid experience. So because the visuals are so close, in my opinion, at 4500 bitrate, I don't really see the advantage of blowing 30% CPU usage and having lower frame rate. The next thing that I want to compare is QuickSync, which I was expecting QuickSync to be a great option. So I've loaded QuickSync in on the right here. So now already I can tell that the one on the right, the QuickSync, looks way worse. And this is at its top quality setting and at 4500 bitrate, the same as the other two. So QuickSync at 4500 bitrate is just not up to snuff in my opinion at all. Performance-wise, it's better than X264 on the CPU, obviously. Compared to the NVIDIA one, let's have a quick peek. So it's just a little bit worse as far as the smoothness, and that's because QuickSync doesn't bump up the core clock either. The CPU usage is lower though. It's about 80% over here, and it's only about 50 to 60 over here. So that's good. The frame rate does stay pretty consistently around 60 frames, where over here we still drop again between 7 and 10. So, but the GPU usage is up at 80%, which is higher than the GPU over here. Well, it's about the same actually, because neither one of them is overclocking the GPU all the way. But if your options are using NVIDIA or using QuickSync, I would go with the NVIDIA option because it's just way better than QuickSync. I mean, just look how pixelated it is on the right for the same bitrate and same file size. So that's just not satisfactory. Now these numbers, these CPU numbers I'm giving you, are based on my processor. And it'll scale differently depending on what processor you use. Some of these things won't even be available to you if you have a weaker processor, because, you know, my 77% might be well over 100% of your processor. I use an Intel i7, it's a quad core with hyper-threading, so 8 threads, and I have it overclocked to 4.5 gigahertz. So it's pretty powerful CPU. And I cannot effectively play Grand Theft Auto 5 with the settings all like maxed out for 1080 with OBS streaming and a third thing running. Let's say I add in a camera into OBS, like for face cam, that is a bit CPU intensive. Even if it takes, say, 10% CPU, or I'm running something else in the background that takes 5-10% of the CPU, any spikes that happen in Grand Theft Auto 5, and it's gonna go down to Stutter City. That's a pretty big problem. So that's why for me, this just wasn't an option, and I have a pretty great CPU. So unless you have an even better CPU than me, and you wanna be able to run X264, or if you have the same or worse CPU than me, I would highly recommend running NVENC. Personally, I still think the NVENC looks great. And for the fact that it's running 40% less CPU, it's a no-brainer for me. And I went through all the different presets for NVENC. See if I can show you the other ones. What do we got? So you've got default, high quality, high performance Blu-ray, low latency, low latency, high quality, low latency, high performance. Now I've heard some things about some of the low latency ones can cause a bit of compatibility problems. I thought some of them looked okay, but I was a little bit weary of that, especially since I didn't actually think they looked as good as default. Blu-ray looks pretty darn good. I don't know that sometimes I had trouble telling the difference between default and Blu-ray. At certain times I thought default looked a little bit better. And default's file size is slightly smaller than Blu-ray, which means you'd get a little bit more bang out of your bitrate when you're streaming. High quality would make you think that it'd be the best one. I actually personally found that high quality had some frame dropping and didn't look quite as good as default. So if it was me, I would put default. And I already explained the other settings earlier. So for me, my current streaming settings, which I'm pretty happy with, is I run the NVENC H.264 codec. I rescale it down to 1280 by 720. I run a constant bitrate of about 4500. It'll have to be 3500 if you're on Twitch, obviously. And again, I've already said this before, but at 3500, the X.264 codec does pull ahead a little bit more than the NVENC. It's still not as bad as it was in the old days when people were writing those posts in like 2011, 12, 13, where they're like, NVENC sucks, it's so horrible looking. It's not that bad. But at 4500 bitrate is where I find it's a little bit more difficult to tell the difference. And in some cases, I would say NVENC might actually be a little bit better. But less than that, and you're gonna have a more efficient codec with the X264, but your CPU usage is gonna go way up. I put the keyframes at 2, I leave the preset at default, I put the profile to high, I don't mess with the levels or the other details like that. And I have been pretty happy with these streaming settings. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I think that's about all that I wanted to cover. That's most of what I've learned over the last 24 to 48 hours trying to figure out how to stream. I know I didn't cover everything that could possibly cover, but I hope that I covered enough to answer some questions if you guys are having similar questions to what I have. But if there's anything else, like I said, let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, please don't forget to give it the old thumbs up. And subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content from me. I don't do stuff like this all the time. Normally I do a lot more fun, goofy kind of stuff. But check out some of my other videos if you're here for a different reason. And hopefully we'll see you around. I'm going to be doing some streaming hopefully now soon too. So subscribe and you'll be notified of when the stream goes up. And then if you have further questions about streaming, you can ask me in there. And I can hopefully answer them for you on the fly and help with your streaming as well. Alright. I'm done.